Hello students, so in the previous class when we were talking about in that of the star and solar system, we discussed about galaxy. What is galaxy, students? So galaxy, it is a system which includes all the stars. It means the million and billion of the stars present in the sky, and these galaxies not only consisting of the stars but the hot gases, dust is also there. So they all are you can say they are joined together, or they are present together due to the attraction, okay, due to the gravitational attraction. Now if we talk about our own galaxy, students, so our own galaxy is Milky Way. Okay, so our sun and stars, these all will be present in a galaxy, and that is Milky Way. Our own galaxy Milky Way is like a faint band of a light which stretches over the sky. Now this is galaxy. If we talk about constellations, so not only this, constellations are what, student? If the stars which is present, and they arrange themselves to give shape or to give pattern, that is known as constellation. Until now we are knowing 88 constellations. And out of that, some of the constellations are very known to us, like that of Ursa Major or Ursa Minor, or Orion is there, or Cassiopeia is there. So these are the constellation which is known to us. In that, students, we discuss about the two type of a constellation. The first one was Ursa Major, and the second one is Ursa Minor. In both the cases, student, the structure means the pattern of the stars are almost the same. It means they are consisting of a 7 bright star, and the other faint star is also there. These 7 bright stars, they arrange themselves like a spoon, or they give a shape like a beer. And that is why this Ursa Major, it is also known as a Big Dipole or the Great Bear. The Great Bear. Okay, so this is the name for the Ursa Major. What about Ursa Minor, student? Here also it consisting of the 7 bright color stars which arrange themselves for giving a shape like that of the spoon, or that like a bio, and that is why, since it is a small in size, and that is why it is not easily recognizable. But in case of a Ursa Major, student, it can be easily recognizable. So Ursa Major is known as the Big Dipole or the Great Bear. Here Ursa Minor is known as the Little Dipole or Little Bear. So these are the different names of both of them, Major and Minor. By this you can understand one is having the shape which is having the brightest star, can be easily recognizable, big in shape. Here the shape is smaller, and that is why the name is given Minor. Now in between these two, students, if suppose you want to find a star, that is stars which remain stationary. What is that star which remains stationary, students? So we had discussed that a pole star is a star which does not seems, which does not appears to be moving like the other stars appears. Okay, why is it so? Because pole star is present at the line of the axis of the earth rotation. It is present at the north pole, and that is why the name is given north pole stars, and it remains the same. So if we want to locate the pole star, so with the help of the Ursa Major we can locate it. How? You just see locate the Ursa Major and find the two brightest stars which is present at the end of the spoon. Okay, so you can see here, this is the Ursa Major, students. We have located Ursa Major, and in this one, students, you see the stars, which is the brightest one. So this is the two end of this spoon, which is having the brightest star. Now, if you extend this star at the north of the direction, at the north axis, student, then what happened? You will find that a very bright star you can find at the north axis. That is known as the pole star. Okay? By looking at this, student, you will find that this is what? This is the tail of that spoon of Ursa Minor. So with the help of the Ursa Major, where the two brightest star, when you extend it in the north axis, then you will find a bright star, which is the tail of that of the Ursa Minor, that is known as a pole star. So with the help of this, you can find the pole star. Okay, so by the help of this, student, we can locate the that of the pole star. Okay, so pole star is a medium bright star. The medium bright star is known as the pole star. Now we will move to the next kind of a constellation, student, and that is Orion. Orion. Now the name Orion, if you see, the Orion is what? It is one of the most brightest, beautiful and easily recognizable constellation which we can see in the night sky. If we talk about the Orion, students, so the name Orion has been given by the name Orion, which has been picked up by a Greek mythological character. Okay, so this is taken up after the name Orion, a Greek mythological character. If you see the pattern of the star in Orion, you will find that there are 8 bright stars are present. And these stars, they have arranged themselves in such a way that they form a body of a hunter. And in that body of a hunter, if you see the middle portion, student, you will find the 3 bright stars are there. And they arrange themselves in such a way that they give a shape of the belt of the dress of the hunter. While the other faint star will give the shape of the shield and the sword. And that is why this constellation is also known as the hunter. Okay, so we can write it about this Orion. So Orion is first thing, it is the one of the most beautiful, easily recognizable prominent and easily recognizable constellation. Okay, so one of the most beautiful, prominent and easily recognizable. Now the constellation is named after Orion, a Greek mythological character. Okay, so this name is given after a Greek mythological character, that is Orion. Now if we see the pattern of the Orion, students. So the pattern of the Orion it consisting of 8 bright stars in it. So 8, it has 8 bright stars, and these stars have arranged themselves by giving a shape of a body of a hunter. So these stars arrange themselves by giving a shape of a body of a hunter. If you see the three stars, students, which is present in this pattern, then you will find the three stars in the middle. Three stars in the middle make up the belt of the dress of the hunter. Belt of the dress of the hunter. Okay. Now, not only this, students, while the other faint stars, forms the sword and shield. Okay, and this is why this constellation is also known as a hunter constellation. So whenever the question is asked that which constellation is known as a hunter constellation, you will say that it is the Orion, which makes the stars to form a pattern to give a shape of a hunter, and that is why we can say it is a what? It is a hunter constellation. Now see, it has the 8 bright stars. The stars, they arrange themselves in the body of by giving the shape of a body of a hunter. The three stars are in the middle, and it make up the belt of that hunter. And while the other star is also there, and they form the shield and sword. So this is what this is about, that of Orion. Now let us understand with the help of the structure of the Orion, students. So you see, what is the structure of Orion? You see, this one. Join all the stars. If we join all the stars like this, students. Okay. So this is what? Okay, so these are what, students? This is the Orion. You can see here, there are the three stars which is present at the belt, which seems it. You can see, if suppose we will consider it as a body. So it seems like a body of a hunter, and in the middle you can see three stars are there students. So three stars, it seems as a belt of the dress of the hunter. Okay, so it is the middle portion, present at the middle portion. So we can say that it seems that it forms the belt of the hunter. Okay, and the other stars, you can see eight are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So eight bright stars are there, three at the middle forms the belt of the hunter, while the other will form the shield and sword. Now you see here students, in this only, if suppose we will extend this line at the east axis, the three stars are which is present in the Orion, if we extend the line which is passing through that of the three stars at the belt or in the middle of this Orion, if we extend it, what we will find? Let us see that. And we are extending it in the east direction. Let me write you. The three stars imagine imagine the three stars. So imagine the three stars are extended towards the east axis. East axis. Then what you will observe, students, you will see that this extended line leads to a brightest star Sirius. Okay, we had discussed about the Sirius also, student, which is the brightest stars that we know. Okay, so if you extend this star at the east axis, then what you will find? You will find a brightest star, and that is known as a Sirius. So if you want to find this brightest star, what you have to do? At first you have to locate the three brightest star of the Orion, and you have to extend the line towards the east direction. The star which comes in the path of this line, we will say that this is the brightest star that is known as Sirius. So you see here, student, with the help of the pattern of the stars, or by extending the line from the star itself, either in any of the direction, either in any of the axis, we can find the other type of a star also. Like in case of a Ursa Major, when we extend the line of this end of the spoon of the two brightest star of Ursa Major towards the north axis, then we find a medium bright star, that is pole star. And when we see the Orion, the belt, that is the three brightest stars which is forms the belt of this structure shape, when you extend it in the east direction, then you will find a brightest star is there, that is known as Sirius. Okay, so this is all about Orion or Sirius. Now we will move to the next one, and that is Cassiopeia. Okay, Cassiopeia. So Cassiopeia, okay, Cassiopeia. Cassiopeia is another kind of a constellation, students, which consisting of a five bright stars. And these bright stars, when we see them, they form a pattern of a distorted M or W. Okay, that is what, that is Cassiopeia. Now, where you will find, where you can locate Cassiopeia, students? So it is basically find at the in the northern hemisphere in winters, if you see, especially during the early part of the night. Okay, so you can see it in the northern hemisphere in winter during the early part of the So this is all about a Cassiopeia. So we can write it. It is the another prominent. It is the another prominent. 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 Prominent constellation. So it is what, student? It is the another prominent constellation. If you see in this Cassiopeia, what kind of a pattern is it? Consisting of five bright stars. So it consisting of a five bright stars, and these five bright stars, they combine together, they form a pattern of a distorted M or W. Okay, so together they form a pattern of distorted M or W. Okay, so they form a pattern of a distorted M or W, that is of the Cassiopeia. Now location, students. So we said that it is located, basically it is found in the northern hemisphere during winter in the early part of night. Okay, so it is located in the northern hemisphere can be seen. It is visible. It is visible in the northern hemisphere. Visible in the northern hemisphere during winter. Winter in the early part of the night. Early part of the night. So this is all about that of the Cassiopeia, students. So what is there in Cassiopeia? It is a kind of a constellation which consisting of a five bright stars, and these stars join together, or we can say these stars form a pattern of a distorted M or W. The structure of the Cassiopeia, students. So I told you that it forms together a distorted W or M. So you can see here what kind of a structure it has, students. So if this is the star, and then this one is also a star, then here, and finally here. Okay, so we can join it all together, and finally you can join together and form a distorted M. Okay, so this one is of what? This one is of Cassiopeia, which consisting of a five bright stars are there, and these stars, they are joined together, they form a distorted M or a W. Okay, so this is the distorted W or distorted M is there. This is the pattern of that of the Cassiopeia. So now see, students, these all are the constellation. The first one that we had discussed is the Ursa Major and the Ursa Minor. Both of them, students, are having the same kind of a pattern, and they form a spoon like a structure or a bear like a structure. That's why we use another term for it. We call it as the big deeper or the great bear for Ursa Major, or the little deeper or little bear for the Ursa Minor. Okay. When you extend the Ursa Major, the two brightest stars at the end of that of the depot, then you will find a medium bright star that is known as the pole star, which do not seems to be changed at its place. It remains stationary. Then if we talk about the next one is the Orion. Orion is for student in which consisting of 8 bright stars, and these 8 bright stars, they arrange themselves in such a way to give a body shape of a body of a hunter. Now this 8 stars consisting of 3 stars at the middle, which gives the shape of a belt of the hunter. Okay. And the other one will form the shield and the sword. When you extend extend a line from that of the three the three bright stars which is present at the belt of the hunter constellation, that is Orion, then you will find another brightest star. When you extend it at the east axis, okay, then you will find another star, brightest star, that is known as Sirius. And finally, Cassiopeia. In Cassiopeia, students, you see it consisting of 5 bright stars, and they arrange themselves to form a distorted M or W. Now when we move to the next one, student, and next one is the solar system. So we talked about that of the stars, how the stars they form the pattern, and how the stars they help in forming the galaxies also. Okay, so you know that a galaxy consisting of a million and billion of stars, and these stars will form a galaxy. The same way, like if you see, if we talk about the Milky Way. So Milky Way is what? Which is having a star, sun, and the other stars also. So these two, form the Milky Way galaxy. Now we will talk about the solar system. The solar system. What is the solar system, student? Basically, the term solar. You see here, the first term which came from this name, from this word, from this system is the solar. Solar is what? The thing that we get from the sun, or the system of sun. So basically, it includes sun and the 8 planets, moon, meteors, okay, and asteroids, dust particles, etc. Okay, so basically this is the system which include all the things, which can include the 8 planet, which includes the moon, its constellation, meteors, asteroid, dust particles, all the things, they together form a system. That system is known as a solar system. And these all are held together by a gravitational force. So we can say that these are held together to each other by a gravitational force. Okay. So, the strong gravitational attraction by that of the sun make all of them to rotate around the sun, revolve around that of the sun. So, you know that in a solar system, the planets, they used to revolve around the sun. So, the planets, they used to revolve, the planets, moon, and its constellation also revolve around the planet. It means it is also revolving around the sun. The dust particle which is present, it also revolves around the sun. The meteors and the asteroid which is present in between to that of the planet will also revolve around the sun. So these all revolve around the sun and they remain together. They do not move from their orbit just because of the strong gravity, strong attraction, force of attraction which exists, which is shown by that of the sun, and that is why they remain in the orbit and revolve. Okay, so this is what this is about the solar system. Now in the solar system, student, the most important part is the sun. Okay, so sun, the first thing that we have to study about the solar system is sun. So sun is what, student? It is the most prominent member of the solar system. Okay, because this is what, this is the member around which the other members they used to revolve. So we can say that it is the most prominent member of the solar system. Okay, if we talk about the sun, it is basically consisting of a hydrogen gas which later on converted into the helium gas. So most prominent member is the sun.